This video will focus on what the I2C Designer tool is and how it can help users design an I2C bus. For users who are new to designing an I2C bus, this tool provides many system checks which can help avoid potential problems and save time. For more experienced users in I2C, this tool can still be helpful in providing assistance in PCB bus capacitance estimation and quick pull-up resistor calculation. The I2C Designer tool is an online tool created to help the user resolve potential I2C challenges, such as address conflicts, VCC conflicts, bus capacitance limits, part selection, pull-up resistor calculations, speed conflicts, buffer placement with respect to VCC, and buffer placement with regard to the static voltage offset. The first design challenge is to ensure the I2C bus does not experience address conflicts, as the I2C standard states slave addresses must be unique in order to prevent data corruption during read transactions. The I2C Designer tool will look for any address conflicts and present workarounds in the case of address conflicts with the use of an I2C switch or MUX. VCC conflicts can result in damage to devices which cannot withstand the higher biasing voltage. The I2C Designer tool will suggest solutions to resolve this using either an I2C level shifter or an I2C switch with a level translation capability. Bus capacitance is a common issue with largely loaded I2C buses, where the I2C spec states the bus capacitance must be less than 400 picofarads or less for standard mode and fast mode. The I2C Designer tool has a built-in capacitance estimator feature, which is based on PCB parasitics. When the capacitance value surpasses the 400 picofarad limit, the tool will suggest I2C buffers to segment the capacitance to comply with I2C standard. One of the most commonly asked questions on the E2E forums is what pull-up resistor to use for a given I2C bus. The I2C Designer tool provides the maximum and minimum pull-up resistor values for each segment for the I2C bus based on the estimated bus capacitance and the maximum I2C frequency. To avoid signal integrity concerns, I2C slaves which operate at different speeds should not coexist on the same I2C bus. The I2C Designer tool will take this into consideration and separate slaves of different maximum operating speeds using an I2C switch or an I2C repeater with a disable feature. When an I2C potential conflict is present, the I2C Designer tool will provide potential solutions the user can select from to resolve the issue. Some I2C buffers have strict rules on how they can be interfaced with other buffers. The I2C Designer tool will ensure any static voltage offset buffers are not connected to each other on their static voltage offset sides. The I2C Designer tool currently does have some limitations. It does not support multiple masters. The slave devices do not include devices outside of the interface portfolio, such as temperature sensors, motor drives, accelerometers, etc. The tool does not support checks for any off-board communication. Lastly, the tool does not take power supply sequencing into consideration. The I2C Designer tool allows for bus designs to be quickly generated and common problems to be automatically addressed. Built-in bus capacitance estimators and pull-up resistor value checkers makes this a useful tool for both experienced I2C designers and those new to the protocol. So try our free I2C Designer tool on TI.com to help simplify your I2C tree.